Hey, oh wow, you look amazing. I'm loving this look you've got right now. I've been such a big fan of yours for the longest time. I remember 16 was my ringtone back in the day.
Oh, what? That's good.
If you listen to
16
it,
16 is like, a pretty good one to have, to be fair. Like,
yeah, if you listen to it, it's like purpose made for a ringtone. So you are joining the Sydney leg of the Synthony show. What
Correct.
About the show?
Well, you know what? I think when you have songs that have stood the test of time, which these are dance classics, right? So they've obviously stood the test of time. And then you kind of plump that up by using something as beautiful and majestic as an orchestra, right? I mean, that's already there. I'm already there for dance classics, but when you put an orchestra behind anything, it makes it sound good. That's why we love the movies so much. And then when you put lasers on top, I mean.
I know, I've actually seen some clips on YouTube, fishers losing it.
Losing it. It sounds insane. It sounds good.
And Soundstorm, oh my God. Have you seen the show at all?
Well, we've already done quite a few, and then COVID kind of interrupted. And some of them were like at half capacity, so we did the Maya Music Bowl. And now we're doing, I think this will be the last couple.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm actually from Sydney, so I really want to see the show. I've seen looks incredible, and I really, really want to see what you're doing. Are you able to spill at all on your involvement in the show?
Listen, I think if you know any Sydney sound system songs, you know that it could possibly only be one or two.
Yeah, gotcha.
Right.
Yeah.
And then I think I'm doing the last song, which is You Got the Love. Oh,
that's going to be incredible. That's really going to be magical. So as I was saying hopefully it still lasts, so haven't been cut at all. Funny story, I was actually in Byron Bay last week, and there's only one place to go in Byron Bay, the nightclub and dancing, and all of a sudden Pictures comes on, and you know, what? Everyone goes crazy, 100%, and I just love that, like, up from so
How
long,
good.
That song still goes up, and I love it so much.
I mean, I really think that it was quite, for a lot of people, it was quite a moment in time. Like, you know, when you hear those songs when you're on Schoolies, for example, and they're kind of ingrained in that moment where you were just kind of bursting into adulthood. Do you know what I mean? Like, you've got this kind of, you're out of the blocks a bit, you know?
Ministry of Sound annual, like, just that time when that was everything.
Yes, correct. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
It's just that time period. I loved it so much.
I think it's true. Like, music really touches you at certain time frames in your life.
Mm.
And those, I think they're like kind of key moments, you know?
100%.
Like, obviously, another key moment would be when you're walking down the aisle. But I mean, it would be kind of good if you had like a throbbing dance track, but maybe you wouldn't do that. I don't know. But that's another key moment that kind of sits there with you.
Talking about another key moment in your life, perhaps, getting to work with Kanye West. I always love pointing out flashing lights. I'm like, that's Connie. And that's such an iconic part of the song as well. How did that come to be?
I think at that point I'd already done kind of worked on two albums with him at that point. And then I think when you're in the studio with any artist, like, you're just in the studio. So it'll be like, oh, Connie, can you just come in and do something on this? And then you go, oh yeah, sure. I'm not doing it. I'm in the studio for a reason. And then you go in there, and then I think you just said, say flashing lights. So I just said it in my best American accent. But there you go.
I love it so much. Something that I've not yet experienced that I know many, many people have over the last 20 years is the Sneaky Sunday show.
I mean, that we've been rolling that out for a long time now. And what that is actually kind of two and a half, 3 hours of like sick house tracks, which is like this, like, of all the great summer destinations that we've ever been to, Mykonos, Ibiza, Spain, you know, these are all rolled into one in that 3 hours of power. It's that beautiful kind of, like, you're outside, sunset moment, and you're just listening to these kind of this journey of house like amazingness. That's what that's how I describe it. And with a little bit of Connie sprinkled in there.
Love just it. A little bit. But you've actually done shows in Mykonos as well, right?
Like we have. We did a season in Mykonos a couple of years ago. We did it for about 3 years at a place called Scorpios.
Fantastic. But I have seen you guys live. I remember about 10 years ago seeing you at my local, The Ranch. It was incredible. I think I was like dancing my butt off and you were like, this guy deserves a free album. So you personally gave me an album.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
You must have been dancing great.
Yeah. It was when We Love came out. So I was like fully into it. Speaking of albums, do you feel like Sneaky will release another album anytime soon?
Yeah, we were actually just talking about that the other night because we were kind of listening to back. You know, you've always got tracks like in on your computer or something, and you kind of forget that you've done all these. You've got this body of work because if you're making music, you're kind of always pumping out music. Mm. But it's not until you actually go back and reflect all these things together, you go, oh my god, there's quite a lot of stuff. It's quite a lot of stuff there. And we were just saying in the last, would have been at least the last week, the last fortnight, that we actually should put that body of work collectively on an album. Because, you know, if you've got that many, you only need a few for an album. You know what I mean?
I can't tell you how happy that makes me. Because I did see in an interview a few years ago that Angus is like, no, I don't think we'll do another album.
Can I just say he's changed his tune?
Yeah, changed his tune. I love it. Okay, that makes me really happy. And what I love about so many of your albums is how random they are. Like literally just singing I Told You to Eat Your Dinner in When We Were Young. I told you to eat your
dinner. Things just come into your brain and they you know, that's just, I think that's being open to being creative. You know what I mean? Like, and I think that's the joy of music, is you can kind of, and painting and art and anything artistic, is you can kind of do whatever you can do whatever you want. There's no rules. And in fact, I remember there was some amazing art teacher or someone who said that when you're doing a painting, there are no rules. It's like whatever it is on the canvas, which is the same, like it can say for music. You know what I mean?
Fantastic.
So it just kind of comes out. It's great. I love that.
I was listening to the radio a few months ago, and I don't know if you ever listened to Kyle and Jackie O, but basically they do this like song battle between each other. Jackie O really wanted Hip Hip Hooray by Sneaky Sound.
There's another, because I love Hip Hip Hooray. Angus goes, oh my god, if I ever hear that song again, but I love it. It's funny how, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's no fun, it's silly.
It's so random, and it's like a good song for a birthday, like. Hip, hip, hooray. But it actually reminded me of another song you had on your first album, which is Yo Ha.
Which I also love too.
And she's like, nah,
they're really, for me, they are like, they were the ones that really worked for my success. And you can see why, because they're just so like.
Yeah, you can just get into it straight away. What is your favourite song to play live?
I Want to Get Somewhere Where We Belong at the moment.
Yeah.
I really like that one.
Yep.
I love UFO too.
It would be so incredible for UFO just to like have everyone sing the song back to you, all the little parts of the song.
I mean,
like you can never really get sick of that, right?
I sing it a lot and I don't get sick of it.
Yeah.
But I mean, you kind of can't get sick of your own children.
You try not to.
Yeah, you try not to. Try and have favorites, but you kind of do.
Yeah, 100%. But it kind of reminds me of like, I just learned that you guys played at Glastonbury and what an incredible experience that would have been. How did that come about?
At that point we were getting played quite a lot on BBC Radio. So, I mean, when you're getting played on the radio in England, you're just kind of automatically added to a lot of those festivals. Hmm. You know, we did the Isle of Wight Festival, did the V Festival. Because you're on the radio, and so you're on the radar. So that's the lineup. What's on the radio is on the lineup. But it was so much fun. We played in one of the biggest tents, and it was just like, it's something that you want to tick off your list, I think.
Yeah, 100%. What else would be on your highlights or, you know, things you look back and create, like, how the hell did I do that?
I think meeting the boys won, because that was just so random. being in a room with Kanye, Jay-Z and Beyonce, that's pretty amazing highlight.
Oh my God.
Playing in Ibiza, playing in Mykonos, getting to travel the world, doing something that you love and seeing the world doing that. That's pretty incredible too, because I mean, that, and that's incredibly lucky too, that you get to be able to do that in life.
Yeah, that's a lot of highlights. That's really incredible. I would love to know more about Beyonce and Jay-Z and Kanye West one day. If you're going to name drop, I don't think you go any bigger than that, you know? but taking it back to, you know, your breakthrough single, I love it. It spent 73 weeks on the ARIA Top 100, breaking the record for the most weeks at that time. I remember that song being so huge, but I don't remember exactly what it was that made it go, you know, 73 weeks. Top 100.
I think there's a lot of tracks that are like that. I remember there was a Sexy Back, kind of was a bit like that.
Yeah.
Just like track. They're just these tracks that kind of just sit there in the ether and they keep bubbling. And I think that was kind of one like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess it could also be like a bit of a discovery. It's like, oh, have you heard of this new band, Sneaky Sounds?
Yes, correct.
Like, this song is so good. Going back to probably what I think will be on the Synthony show, I think UFO possibly might.
I think you may be right there.
You're safe with that. Definitely one of your more successful tracks.
Correct.
Do you remember what inspired the writing of it? Were you fans of like the X-Files or something?
No, I actually did see a UFO.
Oh, really?
I actually did, and I lost some time. It was in the backyard. I was putting some washing on the line, and when I came back, it was like a handful of stuff. And when I came back into the house, people said, "Where have you been? You've been gone for hours."
Yeah.
And
then the alien comes.
There's nothing involved. I'd been drinking like, you know, some soda water. There's nothing. It was purely a lost amount of time. And then when I looked up in the sky, there was these three little dots that just went like
that. Really? Wow.
And then just went, pfft.
No way.
Yeah. And then I came inside and
I love it.
Said to my partners, and they said, "Well, no, you didn't. No way."
No one believed.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah, yep. No one believed. And then I said,
"You've seen it." I mean, so you
Well, that's right.
Yeah.
I'm down with that now.
I love it.
I didn't need to stretch them out. I'm like, yeah, I get it. Okay.
See me, Elliot. That's cool.
Yeah. Weird, random. People didn't believe me, so I was crazy, but yeah.
So you've already cleared up the rumors. You have seen any UFO, and I'm choosing to believe you. Let's talk about some other conspiracies and get Connie's tips on this. So first of all, is Tupac Shakur still alive?
Yes. I was thinking about that the other day. I think it could be.
Okay, yeah. I mean, people have said that side of him, and people who
I reckon. Because he was such a soft soul, and I think maybe it got a bit much for him, and he went, you know what, I'm going to go into hiding.
Yeah, maybe. Makes sense. Yeah, why not? Yeah. Second one, is Khloe Kardashian OJ's daughter? I could see how much you care about this topic.
I could see how people would think that.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
No, okay. So no.
Just the way like Prince Harry and Prince William, I mean, you know, one's got ginger hair. I mean, but they're still brothers. They're still, there's nothing. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, 100%.
Genetics is a weird pot.
Was the moon landing staged?
It could have been.
It could have been.
It could have been. I've heard a few rumors about that too.
Yeah.
A couple of deathbed rumors going, we had a sound.
You've seen a UFO.
Sound stage. You know? So, yeah, I think so.
Fantastic. Do you believe in ghosts?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you have a story or?
No, thank goodness.
No, yeah.
I mean, I think when I was little, I think in the house, all the cupboards used to rattle in the middle of the night.
Ooh.
Every cupboard, every yeah. single cupboard.
Would you ever do like a ghost tour?
No.
No.
I'm not mucking around with that. No.
No way. No, no way.
Uh-uh.
I'm sure you've heard about Dolly the sheep back in 1996. You got cloned.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you believe that humans have already been cloned?
Yes.
Oh, I like that.
For sure. They did that all the way back then, were they just going to sit on it? Like some ridiculously rich billionaire owner of the World Bank isn't going to get himself like a little, you know.
Doesn't that freak you out?
Now is taking your brain out to put it into taking all the information you've stored over your life and putting it into your phone. Downloading it.
You see a UFO once and this is where your brain goes.
Right?
I'm freaking out. And now this last one's controversial and I didn't actually realize how controversial it was until I realized you've actually met them. So go light on me. Jay-Z, Kanye and Beyonce, part of the Illuminati controlling the world. Do you even know what I'm talking about?
Could be. That doesn't mean that that's a bad Illuminati. They could be like a good Illuminati doing some like wicked stuff.
You know? I love it. Yeah, why not? Okay. I mean, who doesn't love Jay-Z, Kanye, and Beyonce? So.
Well, that's right. I just don't think good people like that. Maybe they've formed a group to do good.
Yeah.
You know, that makes sense.
I feel you.
And they want everyone to go, "Oh, you're so amazing! You did this." You know? Because people don't talk about it.
Do you watch Beyonce's films? Like, I feel like a lot of people are missing out on pure greatness if you've not watched Beyonce's films.
Oh, I mean, it's beautiful. And you can tell that person's a beautiful person.
Mm. Mm.
And when you meet her, she just radiates goodness.
Yeah. Like. Yeah, 100%. So thank you so much for your chat. I just want to know, is there anything that I can expect on the horizon? You said there possibly is an album coming out.
You know what? Always new stuff from Sneaky.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely a new album's definitely being thought about as we speak.
Well, I'll be waiting and I'll be going to the show as soon as you announce it.
Hey.
Thank you so much for your chat.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Bye.